Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. Make sure you check out the video description for info about upcoming conference workshops and swag and ways that you can support the channel, as well as buying books that I have published. In this episode, I'm going to talk a little bit about ABI, ODR violations, and tools that can prevent you from making those mistakes. All right, this episode is presumably going to be pretty short. Let's give it a go. Now, I have this simple interface here where I've got something that uses data and a forward declared data, and I have something that provides data and a forward declared data. And in my main, I am using data with the get data. And my use data function simply prints x and y. And my getData function has the values 1.23 and 4. And I execute this, and without any real meaningful warnings, this is just a warning about CMake here, I am getting what is clearly the absolutely wrong value printed, but no other warnings to speak of from the compiler. So what went wrong here? Now, if you were paying careful attention, you might have observed that in file 1.cbp, I have data declared as float y int x, and as file 2.cpp, I have it as int x float y. So the layout is different between these two types. But the compiler has no visibility into that. This is a very clear ODR violation. This is also a problem with ABI. And ODR stands for one definition rule. That is, you can have only one definition of a thing in a project. And ABI is the application binary interface. And these are things that I have talked about in previous episodes. Now I'm going to show you a neat little trick that I recently learned that can tell us when things have gone awry. In my CMake file, I have this option to enable interprocedural optimization. And I did an episode specifically about IPO not that long ago. So I'm just going to go ahead and enable that. And we're going to go back to our output window here. And we're going to see that we now actually get a link time error that says struct data violates the C++ one definition rule. A different type is defined in another translation unit. The first difference of corresponding definitions is field Y. A field with a different name is defined in another translation unit. So right there you have it. That is the entire issue found for you by your compiler and debugged. Problem solved. No reason to worry about ABI or ODR issues at all anymore. You just simply have to use IPO, which is also known as link time optimization. Now I'm saying this slightly tongue-in-cheek, because obviously it's not going to catch 100% of all issues, but I am now leaning strongly in towards saying that IPO or LTO should always be the default for your programs. It can catch an entirely new class of bugs. In many cases, actually results in faster build times. Now, builds are faster, links are slower, but if you use a modern linker such as Mold, then you're going to get much faster linking and results in higher performing code. So it's kind of hard to find a downside here, except for the fact that you have to compile all of your dependencies with IPO enabled to get all of the benefits and prefer static linking. Well, anyhow, thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly.